The committee, under stewardship of its chairperson, Mwine Paka, the MP Mbara City South, had an internal meeting today and agreed to summon complainants, including movers and seconders of the censure motion, plus all other legislators willing to testify. On the same day, Namuganza is summoned to appear and cross-examine witnesses.
We have agreed to furnish all the stakeholders with the relevant evidence and documentation on Thursday morning session between 9 and 1 p.m. We are going to interact with the movers and the seconders. Then in the afternoon, we are going to invite any member of parliament who may have any supporting information, whether positive or negative, and evidence.
But the embattled minister is expected to appear before the committee on Friday to defend herself on accusations labelled against her. Mpaka says their work is to look for credible evidence, and if complainants fail to prove a prima facie case, they will be left with nothing but recommend otherwise.
The burden of proof in this case lies with the mover, not the honourable minister. The honourable minister, who is the accused, is innocent in this case. So the burden of proof lies with the movers. The movers are the ones who are supposed to bring the evidence and not the minister. Should the movers fail to bring evidence that qualifies to be to establish a prima facie case, then the law will apply.
Although Namuganza told Bukedi TV yesterday that she will not appear before Mwine's select committee, Mwine says she will be doing a disservice to herself because the committee was established to enable the accused persons get fair hearings.
Inze na wava, inze gwe bayita, sija biri nyayo, bakole byona bayogera, obibayagala kubanga babikola dda.
Chairperson representing the committee members and the parliament, in the past ministers were censored without such a process. This process has just been established to protect, to give the accused an avenue to defend themselves. If the minister does not appear, she will have given up her right, and the committee will proceed ex parte.
It's our right to come or not to come. It's just like my right. I've been invited. I would have also hoped not to go. But the fact that if you want to help the nation, I would advise her to come. If she refused to come, I think she would be doing a disservice to herself, not to me. To herself.
John Amos Okot, the Agago North representative who moved the Namuganza censure motion, noted that he is ready to face the committee and prove a case of censure beyond reasonable doubt.
I am ready to go and adduce all the necessary information according to my own reach. But remember, the information that we are talking about is not only with me. This is concerning majority of Member of Parliament.
Meanwhile, two MPs, Charles Tebandeke of Bale County and Susan Mugabi Nakaziba, the woman representative of Buvuma Islands, have petitioned the Constitutional Court, challenging the assent of bills by the President beyond the constitutionally mandated 30 days. Their petition comes after the President declined to assent to the Fisheries and Aquaculture Bill 2021 after keeping it on his desk beyond 30 days.
We want the court to declare that since the President had failed to conduct his exercise within the 30 days time duration, all the proceedings, the debate, the scrutiny, and the consideration on the same bill should be judged void and null and unenacted.
Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.